Hi, good morning. Welcome to SSV IIT classes. I am Basha, faculty of class. We are going to discuss about the 8th class analytical geometry. In previous class, we discussed transformation of axis. There are two types of transformations, translation of axis and rotation of axis. Then, about a straight line, perpendicular distance. How to find the perpendicular distance from a point to the line? Let us a line AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. A is perpendicular distance from x1, y1 gives us AX1 plus BY1 plus C by square root of A square plus B square. Which we wrote this condition at the time of normal form of a line. X cos alpha plus y sin alpha plus is equal to P, standard form. Or AX plus BY plus C, we have a condition A by square root of A square plus B square into X plus B by square root of A square plus B square into Y is equal to minus C by square root of A square plus B square. From that two, we will get the perpendicular distance of a line. Let us draw two coordinate axes, X and Y, and we are transforming the origin to another point without changing the direction of the coordinate axis. That is, this is x dash and y dash. So let us, this is P x naught y naught. Means it is known as a translation of axis. Means we are changing the position of origin and the direction of coordinate axis are not changed. Let us draw a line AB, AB, the standard form. Equation of the line, equation of the line, AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. Means it is in terms of X and Y. Let us draw a perpendicular from P to line. Consider it is as M, X comma Y. Then the transformation, already we know that origin is changed to P and the coordinates of M, X comma Y also changes. Then X is equal to capital X plus X naught, Y is equal to capital Y plus Y naught, which gives us the new coordinates of X and Y. With respect to the new coordinates, by substituting the coordinate values in the given line, then the equation of line, equation of AB with respect to P on the axis, then we will get a new equation of line AX plus X dash plus BY plus Y naught, or Y dash you can keep, plus C is equal to 0. From here to, by applying A into X, A into X naught, AX plus AX naught, BY plus BY naught plus C is equal to 0. From here to, I am writing it is as A capital X plus B capital Y plus A X naught plus BY naught plus C is equal to 0. Equation 2. This is the given equation as 1. It is as equation 2. So we are finding the perpendicular distance from origin to equation 2. So means already we know the condition perpendicular distance from a point x1, y1 to given line AX1, BY1, C by square root of A square plus B square. By using this condition from 0, 0 to equation 2 perpendicular distance means PM is equal to, means there with respect to the new coordinate system, the X and Y values will become 0. A into 0 modulus of A into 0 plus B into 0 plus A X naught plus B Y naught plus C by square root of X coordinate plus Y coordinate squares. Means then PM is equal to A X naught plus B Y naught plus C by square root of A square plus B square. Already we wrote this condition in normal form of a line. Same. Similarly, we will get that this by using the translation of axis,
without changing the direction, by changing the origin to another point, by using the translation form, substituting in the equation 1, you will get a standard form of new equation with respect to the axis. By finding the perpendicular distance from origin to the equation 2, we will get the perpendicular form, distance from a point to the given line. This is the equation for perpendicular distance of a line from a point. Here point is x0, y0. Here in previous class we discussed it is x1, y1. So both are same. The next one is distance between parallel lines. Distance between parallel lines. What is a parallel line? Means if the two lines which are equidistant at anywhere in the plane is known as a parallel line. Let us considering it is as L, it is as M. L and M are two parallel lines. So we have a condition, if the two lines are parallel, if the two lines are perpendicular, we have the general form. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 is a line. Then a line which is parallel to the given line is Ax plus by plus k is equal to 0. Except the constant remaining x and y coefficients are same in the ratio, then they are in parallel. Are these two are parallel, 1, 2 are parallel. With respect to 1, we want to write a perpendicular to the Ax plus by plus c. Bx minus ay plus k is equal to 0. K are constant, K1. So observe, the x coefficient and y coefficients are interchanged with negative sign. This is the perpendicular line to the 1. So it is clear, this is the standard form of a line. 2, it is parallel to the equation 1. It is parallel to the perpendicular to the equation 1. These are the, 1 is parallel, 1 is perpendicular. So I am writing here, the two lines are parallel. The equation of first line is Ax plus by plus c is equal to c1 is equal to 0, and the second one is Ax plus by plus c2 is equal to 0. The constants only different. The distance between two parallel lines is, let us, the intersection point is P. I am taking it is as x1, y1. Means P lies on the equation 2. Means P lies on equation 2, substituting in on 2. So Ax1 plus By1 plus C2 is equal to 0. From here to Ax1 plus By1 value is equal to minus C2. Let us consider it is as equation 3. Then I am finding the perpendicular distance from P to equation 1. This is equation 1, this is equation 2. Perpendicular distance from P to equation 1. Already we find a formula to find the perpendicular distance from point to a line. Ax0 plus by0 plus cy square root of a square plus b square. By using this condition, observe. Perpendicular distance from P, x1, y1 to equation 1. Equation 1 means Ax plus by plus c1 is equal to 0. So the perpendicular distance means I am taking it is also M. PM is equal R, already wrote M. PQ. PQ is equal to the perpendicular distance from x1, y1 to point is AX1 plus BY1 plus C1 by square root of A square plus B square. By substituting the x1, y1 values in the AX plus BY plus C1, x1, y1 plus C1 in numerator, x coefficient and y coefficient squares in square root, a square root of a square plus b square. So from equation 2 already we know ax1 plus by1 value is minus c2. So substituting minus c2 plus c1 by square root of a square plus b square. By rearranging it, c1 minus c2 by square root of a square plus b square gives us the distance between two parallel lines. And in this class we discussed about the distance between two parallel lines and the distance, perpendicular distance from a point to the line. So that gives the perpendicular distance from a point to the given line, which is in standard form, ax1 plus by1 plus c by square root of a square plus b square. And the distance between two parallel lines is c1 minus c2 by square root of a square plus b square. Already we know that the two parallel lines are, which are x and y coefficients are equal or in same ratio, the constants are different. At that time we will use this idea. Thank you for watching.